What's going on, everybody? It's your bro here. Hope you're doing well. And in this video, I'm going to teach you guys how we can use the Canvas widget to draw some simple shapes. So sit back, relax, and enjoy the show. If you find this video helpful, please remember to like, comment, and subscribe. Your support will help keep this channel running. Welcome back, everyone. Well, in this video, we're going to be creating a canvas. A canvas is a widget that is used to draw simple graphs, plots, and images within a window. We're going to be creating some simple shapes in this video, not anything too sophisticated. I might get more into the canvas widget in a separate video. And at the end of this lesson, we're going to practice by creating a Pokeball. So to begin, we'll need a window. Window equals TK followed by window.main loop. To create a canvas, we can just simply call this canvas. Canvas equals canvas, and we're adding this canvas to our window. And then we need to follow this with canvas.pack or place. But I'm just going to use pack because it's simple. This is what our canvas looks like. It's a rectangular area which we can draw graphics on. We can also set the width and the height of this canvas. So when we create this canvas, we're going to set the options for a height and a width. So let's begin with the height. Height equals, let's say, 500, and the width will be the same, 500. And now we have a square canvas that we can draw graphics on. Let's begin by creating some simple shapes, maybe a line. I think a line is a shape, maybe a one-dimensional one. I don't know, I don't geometry. So let's create a simple line. So we type the name of the canvas, dot create, and there's a bunch of different shapes that we can create. Let's create a line. Now I'm just going to turn this into a comment for a moment. We need to set some coordinates for this line. This top left corner of our canvas is 0, 0, and the bottom right corner of this canvas is 500 by 500. Depends on what you set the dimensions of the canvas to. So when we create a line, we need a starting point and an ending point. So if we want this to start in the top left corner, we're going to pass in 0, 0. That is the starting position. And we can place the coordinates for the ending position. If we want this line to end in the bottom right corner, that would be where x is 500 and y is 500. And this is what this looks like. We just have a simple line going across the screen. But that's not all. We can also change the color of this line and the thickness. Let's begin by changing the color. So we can do that with fill. Fill equals, let's pick the color blue. And now we have a blue line going across the screen. But we can also change the width of this as well. So we can do that using the width option. And let's set this to 5. Now we get an extra thick line across the screen. Now let's make a red line. So I'm just going to copy this, canvas.createLine, and let's change some coordinates for this. Let's say we want this to start in the bottom left corner and go up to the top right. So the starting x position would be 0, y would actually be 500, x for the ending position would be 500, and y would be 0. Let's set this to red, and we'll keep the width the same. Okay, so here's our red line, and notice that this red line is overlapping the blue line. So when you create shapes on a canvas, if there's any that overlap, the one that you most recently created will appear on the top. One option available to you is that you can actually give these graphics a unique name. With our blue line, we could call this blue line. Blue line equals all of this, and then we can call our red line something different, like red line. This would be useful if you want to call or use a graphic by its name. If you want to like move a graphic on the screen or have something appear, you can use this by its name. But we don't really need it for this lesson, so I'll just revert this back to what we had previously. I'm just letting you know that you can do that. All right, what do we have up next? Let's create a rectangle. So canvas.create rectangle. We can set some starting coordinates and ending coordinates. The starting coordinates are for the top left of the rectangle, and the ending coordinates are for the bottom right. So for the starting coordinates, let's say we're going to place this where x is 50, y is 50. For the ending coordinates, we want this where x is 250 and y is 250. I'm just making up numbers. Put it wherever you want, really. And this is what this looks like. But I think I'm going to comment out these lines for now. And here is our rectangle. Well, I guess it's also a square. We can actually give this a fill color as well. So we do that with the fill option. Fill equals purple, I guess. And now we have a purple rectangle. Next on our list is create polygon. We can create many sorts of shapes using create polygon, but it really depends on how many coordinates that we enter. Let's create a simple triangle, so we need at least 3 coordinates for this to work. So canvas.create polygon, and I have some coordinates picked out already. So let's place the first set of coordinates where x is 250, y is 0, for the second set where x is 500 and y is 500, and the last set, the third set, we'll place this where x is 0 and y is 500. And what this looks like is that we have this black triangle that's taking up most of the canvas. We can also change the fill color as well. So we do that with the option fill. And we can set this to whatever color you want. Let's say yellow. And we now have a yellow triangle on our screen. And it kind of resembles the Triforce from the Legend of Zelda series, one of my personal favorites. Let's also add a border. This is actually done with outline. Outline equals, and then pick a color for the outline. Let's say black. And we have a black outline around this graphic. And you can also change the thickness of this too with width. And let's set the width to 5. And now we have an extra thick line around our triangle. With these shapes, you can pass in a list of points too. So I'm going to get rid of all of these and we're going to pass in a list. So let's create a list called points. Points equals all the points that we just entered in previously. And then instead of passing in all of these coordinates individually, I'm just going to pass in our list of points. And this will work exactly the same. Okay, let's create an arc now. So canvas.create arc. An arc is really just a curved line between 2 points. However, when we list some coordinates, we're not listing the coordinates of the starting position and ending position for this arc. It's more or less for the amount of space that we want to allocate to actually draw this arc. So let's say that we want this arc to take up the entire canvas. We can pass in the dimensions for this canvas. So the top left corner is 0, 0, and the height and the width are 500. So this is our arc. It resembles a pie slice. It's not starting in the top left corner and ending down here. That's the amount of space that we're giving this create arc function to actually draw an arc. It's really an entire circle, but only a portion of it is visible. Let's also set a fill color for this. So fill equals, what color did we not pick yet? Let's say green. And now we have a green pie slice. There's different styles you can do too. So we can change that with style equals, the default is pie slice. That's what we had previously. Let's change this to chord. This will draw a line between these 2 points, and this kind of resembles like a bow with arrows. And there is also just arc, where it's simply just a curved line. Let's change this back to pie slice, well, because I like pie. We can change the starting position of where this arc begins with the option start. So start equals 0 by default, so there's going to be no apparent change. Let's adjust this by 90 degrees. So this is in degrees. So this shifted, what is this direction? Counterclockwise by 90 degrees. So 180 would theoretically flip this. And now this is on the other side of what we had previously, and then 270. All right, we can also set an extent. So the default is normally 90 degrees, but let's change this to 180. And now we have a, what is that, hemisphere? Half a circle? All right, people, let's practice by creating a Pokeball. There's still one more function that we have to cover. It's called create oval, but we'll do that as we're making this. So let's begin by creating the top red hemisphere of this Pokeball. So that's canvas.create arc. And we're going to set the extent of this to 0, 0, 500, 500, so that this is going to take up the entire canvas. And then let's also set a fill color to red. So fill equals red. We need to change the extent of how far this extends. So we'll do that with the extent function. So extent equals 180, so that this is a half circle. And let's also change the thickness of this outline as well using the width option. So width equals 10 would be good. And we have a red hemisphere for the top of our Pokeball. Let's work on the bottom half. So that is a white hemisphere. So canvas.createArc, these are all the same. We'll change the fill to white. The extent will be the same, but we need a different starting position. So start equals 180. So this is going to begin at the 180 degree mark. So when you combine these both together, we get two different colored hemispheres that form a perfect circle. Now let's create an oval within the center of this Pokeball. So we're going to do that with canvas.createOval. We're going to set the amount of space that we want to give the circle to be drawn. So we'll place this where X is 190, where Y is 190, where X2, or the second X position, is 310, and Y2 is 310. Let's set the fill color next. So we do that with fill. Fill equals white. And lastly, let's just give this a thicker border. So that is width equals 10 to match the width for the two arcs that we have. And there you have it. We have a simple Pokeball. All right, well, that's the basics of the Canvas widget. If you'd like a copy of all this code, I'll post all of this in the comments down below. But yeah, that's the basics of the Canvas widget in Python.
Hey, you. Yeah, I'm talking to you. If you learn something new, then you can help me help you in three easy steps by smashing that like button, drop a comment down below, and subscribe if you'd like to become a fellow bro.